You got me right on the front door, I'm like, yeah.
Yeah. Got it? Yeah, you can, right? that was the same thing. If I do this here, I'm just going to break, don't let me move. I'm just going to break my pinky. So this is weak, and this is strong. There's a lot of ways to use that dichotomy of leverage. However, I'm going to get to the end of the how to hold the sword. So you're going to be tempted to want to do this. So what you want to do is act like you're shaking someone's hand, or like you had a TV remote in your hand. I'll flash some people by that example, and it'll be like this. So the reason that you do this is it's going to prevent or monitor, which is singularity. What I mean by that is if I'm doing this and I cut at you, and I get to this point, I can't lower my point anymore, like my wrist is locked out here. However, if I change my hand to this, now I can move my hand more. So, if in the sense of, if you cut at my sword, I'm going to do this. As you cut at my sword, I can move that through and still threaten you, right? But if I do it this way, only way to move my sword is with a big, gross motor move. So, this allows you to do fine manipulation of the sword. There's also this grip, which is a thumb grip. This thing's kind of weird, but it's really important also. Thumb grips are primarily used for short edge cuts. I'm going to show you some of the short edge cuts in a bit, and if you don't do this right, you're not going to be able to do it well. There's a couple other grips like this, which I don't really use much. You also do have this, but it's generally bad. You also have this, and I will never do this. You'll get your finger broken too bad. So backhand. Backhand is either going to be just over the pommel or on the pommel. If it's on the pommel, you can think of that as a ball joint where it's just moving around and allows you to do manipulation. When you have your hand over the pommel like this, you're going to be able to cut a little harder. If you do your hands like this, you're going to cut incredibly hard. The reason for that is you can actually feel it. So everyone, do this individually, not to take up any of them. You don't have much space. But hold your hands together, then swing fairly hard straight down, and then try to stop it. And you can feel, if you just try to stop immediately, like, try to stop it, like, right there, you feel like it kind of wants to, like, point down and come back up. Now, if you do the same thing with your hands all the way down, like, you can stop it there, like, no problem. Here, you have more control over the rotation of the weapon. Here, it wants to rotate on its own. Like, when I strike harder, like, it's really hard to get that to stop. So, this gives you more leverage, because this is the smaller lever with the bigger lever, right? So, the way you grip should not be hard. Literally, one of the quotes in, I think it was Mangianello, an Italian guy, he says, pretend that the sword is a little bird. You want to hold the bird hard enough so that it can't get away, but not so hard that you kill it by crushing it. So, you're going to do this, and it's going to be light. So, and if he cuts at me, like, so I want you to just cut at my sword. Like, go ahead and cut hard. Like, I'm not holding the sword hard. Matter of fact, I'm going to do this. So go ahead and cut the sword again. It did not fly on my hand. If I have another hand on there and I do that, I could literally just do this now. Like, open ring, not even holding it. Go ahead. It doesn't matter. You don't have to hold the sword. However, if you want to make a solid cut and you want to make the strike effective, you have to tighten your grip as more slightly. Obviously, you want to do it exactly as long as that clip. So don't hold the sword hard. You're going to be holding like this or this, depending. Backhand is either just above or on. If you want to be a dick, then here. There's four basic cuts. There's also five Meister power. That's all we're going to do tonight. I'm not going to spend a huge amount of time on it. But the first guard is called on top. It means from the room or from the day. So it's more or less at the shoulder. You'll notice with me is I actually have my hand all the way back. You notice that my hand is in that same orientation, and your wrist ends up being cocked kind of weird. Like, my hand is actually cocked back. But I can get really fast extension from here as I come out. The reason your hands are back, if you were fighting me,
you know, I would do this.
Where do you want to be?
I want to hit right here.
What's closer?
Yeah.
So you have to put yourself in more danger with my hand if my hand is not doing good. Like, this wrist is almost a foot close to my wrist. So the further out you keep your hand, the more danger you're in. So sooner we need kind of back and tucked in. Like, I want to keep my hands tucked in. I don't want to do this because once again, if I know that I'm doing this and my arm is in a lot of danger, it's not necessarily bad. I'm going to take a shot saying, hey, try to get this. Anyway, so my pog is really to cut through the main cut. This is probably what I would say is the main cut. But the main cut is called a rat cut. It's really simple. If you hand an angry person a sword, it's most likely going to do this. It's because you can employ the most muscle. From here, I'm just going to get the diagonal down. So, why is that the most powerful effect? Number one, I'm engaging my motion to push out, but I'm also engaging my lats to pull down. Especially from up here, now I can just like pull down that entire thing. So I'm using big
muscles.
So, one. So you guys can cut into the middle. Just cut, and you can go all the way through, or you can stop here. What you're going to want to do with your feet, left foot forward, right foot back, unless you're wrong-handed. Then it's going to be right foot forward, left foot back. The reason for that is primarily one of distance and one of power. If I was fighting you, and I had my right foot forward, and I'm going to get in right distance. So here, I can't hit you, right? If I step a few steps, I still can't hit you, right? I'm going to step back. So now I'm going to push my feet. Now, if I try to do that same thing, right, it's distance. You get a lot more distance with passing stuff than you do with gathering stuff, or simple stuff, depending on what you want to call it, or lunge. But when you make this cut, you're going to be left foot forward, right foot back. You're going to move your hands first. One thing to do is if you watch my right hand as I do this, my right hand moves straight forward and then I fall through down. So if you watch that, it's cut. And you notice I'm not doing this because I'm not fighting a mission. Okay. Sword first, arm strength extension, and then fall. Try again. Okay, that's all right. Second group, go ahead. So the biggest thing with this, and this obviously changes with when you're fighting, but a 45-minute cut. So I'll show you why. So if you cut vertically to me, like straight down to my head, and I cut vertically to you, like not good, right? If you cut vertically to me and I cut diagonal to you, is this good for me? If you cut horizontally this way, and I cut diagonal, is this good for me? Yeah. So 45 degrees generally gives you the most protection. Generally, however, that's not to say that it's all encompassing. So if you have diagonally to me, are you protected?
Nope.
So just because you cut diagonally doesn't mean you win. But it is a strong, fast cut, and has good jump. So if you're really seeing me as a default cut, you're going to be aiming like either here or here. The why of that is a little bit more complicated, but we're moving on. So the next cut is literally a vertical cut. Now we're going to do it from a different guard, different cut. So this is called top. So you'll notice that the guard where my knuckles are is facing away from me. This is a Y away from me. Right? So, if you can hit this guard and point that at me, it's a little high support, like full clear, and it's like a little bit. So, it doesn't have to be like perfectly in one place. And what I'm trying to do, so if I cut at you, like you don't have to move your head first, they'll point at my face. So like click here, bring it forward, back end up. There you go, so this is pretty good. If I cut at your head, you don't have to move your head. Like even where it's top, here, back end up. Yeah, if I cut, don't move your head. If I cut at your head, hands a little higher. Higher. There you go. If I cut. Good. So here, turn that out because you're on. If you have it like this, and I cut, it's just right into your knuckle. You see that? So if I cut, watch your thumb. Yep. It's just going to land right into there. Same thing. Yours looks pretty good. The only thing you can do is change it up and lean it a little bit higher and towards me. Right? So now, like, if I cut you, I'm going to not do the other two basic cuts. I'll show you them. So we just did vertical, we did diagonal, we just do horizontal, we didn't do right. I'm not going to do horizontal right. Although the right cut is pretty cool. I'll send it them. And it cuts at my head. So I can do a rising cut into his head, and this is kind of cool. So you're thinking, sort of like do a rising cut and he's cutting from above, because I don't get the head smash, so I'm cutting down here. So I can be lazy cutting his head. And it doesn't matter if it's just an actual like, I can still over here. It actually works better with him than you, but height does make a difference in those things. Being taller is better. Because primarily, if I'm fighting him, you're the shortest one, I think. So, if I do full extension of my arm, it's to his head. He does full extension of his arm, it's to my chest. So, what happens a lot of times is, if you cut diagonals like this near my chest, and I cut the diagonal to his head, you'll notice I'm strong on me. That's what we were talking about earlier. And for my feet, I'm just going to blow through.